In this video, we'll learn the names and functions of the controls and connectors for the Nikon Z6II, Z7II. First, let's look at what the parts of the camera are called. These controls are found on the top of the camera. These controls are on the front. These controls are on the back. These connectors are on the side of the camera. Now, let's look at what these controls are for. Use the photo movie selector to switch between photo and movie modes. Press the sub-selector up, down, left, or right to position the focus point. Keep the center pressed to lock exposure and focus. Press the DISP button to cycle the display as shown. The monitor also functions as a touchscreen. You can angle the monitor as shown. There are two slots in the camera grip, one for CF Express or XQD memory cards, and the other for SD memory cards. Use the monitor mode button to choose from four monitor modes. At the default setting of automatic display switch, the eye sensor will automatically switch the display from the monitor to the viewfinder when you put your eye to the viewfinder, and back to the monitor when you take your eye away. If the image in the viewfinder is not in focus, focus can be adjusted by lifting and rotating the diopter adjustment control. You can choose the roles played by the FN1 and FN2 buttons. At default settings, the FN1 button is used for white balance and the FN2 button to choose the focus and AF area modes. Hold the button and rotate the command dials to choose a setting. When a battery is inserted in the camera, an EH7P charging AC adapter can be used to power the camera or charge the battery. Confirm that Enable is selected for USB power delivery in the setup menu. The adapter will provide power to the camera when the camera is on and charge the battery when it's off. Computers or portable chargers with Type-C USB connectors can also be used to power the camera or charge the battery. Take photography to the next level with the Z6II, Z7II's many features.